Shalom, Yahshalah, Shalom. First and foremost, I want to give all praise, honor, and glory to the Most High Yahweh. I do so in the name of His only begotten Son, Yahweh Shai. Double honors to the apostles and the elders of Yahshalah. Call Haloyim Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shai, Bahashem Haraka Kodash. We're blessing our elders with the spirit of truth so that we may know. Shout out to the Akim and the Akwath that's keeping the faith and the works. Y'all keep at it. It's your brother Abiah coming at you with more precepts. It's the book of Proverbs, chapter 29 and verse 2. When the righteous are in authority, the people rejoice. But when the wicked beareth rule, the people mourn. The people have been mourning just as long as these wicked individuals have been ruling because of the things that they do on this earth, the different experiments, the different studies. Right? Like mad scientists, man. And you best believe they implement a lot of those wicked hypotheses and experiments on people. Yeah. And we witness it every day. One main thing that I always question was what's in the air? And I ain't just talking about like clouds and rain and water and things, but what airway, what's in the airwaves? What frequencies are being used? What's the hertz that they're using? Frequencies is the number of hertz, if I'm not mistaken. And hertz is like a specific tone, like a specific vibration, right? And what are they using these things for, right? So let me see. Scripture says that we are not ignorant of Satan's devices or evil plans. We understand that one of this devil's evil plans is to ensure that we have a certain mindset, all of the people, but more so Yahshalah, because the minute that we get our mind back, that means that's the end of their kingdom, right? So the Most High has blessed me to put together a few videos to try to get a point across, and Yahweh Ratzizah is clear, the point that I'm trying to get across or the point that he wants to get across, right? And we're going to add scripts right along with it, right, to make sure we keep it spiritual. One of these scriptures is the book of Psalms, chapter 10 and verse 2. Says the wicked in his pride doth persecute the poor. Let them be taken in the devices that they have imagined. Right? These different wicked plans that they have pushed on the Most High's people one of these days, and one of these days soon, it's going to turn. And to be real with you, one of them already have. Because they created something called YouTube. And they didn't create YouTube for the truth to be out there. They created YouTube to keep us blinded in another way. They figured that we wouldn't use that tool. We'll just use it to, you know, record fights and other folly that we do all the time, right? As so-called blacks, so-called Hispanics, and so-called Native Americans, right? But the devil didn't understand the Most High had him create that tool for the apostles to get on it and to teach us the truth and for the rest of the Hebrews to wake up, you know, via different camps, right? The devil didn't understand he was really creating his demise, because he created a way for information to freely go throughout all of the earth, right? Daniel 12 and chapter 4, I believe. Right, but with that being said, I'm going to let this video play and I'll be back.
In the modern era, radio waves control everything. From the tunes in your car driving down the road to the police radio in the car that's pulling you over for not signaling your turn. These waves are undetectable and invisible to human senses, but they make up the foundation of modern connected technology. While the root of modern connected technologies may be radio waves, the underlying tech that makes radio waves possible is a rather simple concept to understand.
The Google Pixel 6 takes it to the next level with what's like magic eraser.
Transmitted. Bringing all of these different techniques back into the real world, we can begin to understand them a little further. If you sit in your car and tune your radio to AM 680, that means that the transmitting station was operating at 680,000 hertz, meaning that the sine wave repeats 680,000 times per second. The voice of the speaker or the music on the transmitting side is modulated onto that wave through amplitude modulation. Then the signal is amplified up to 50,000 watts for larger AM radio stations and then sent into space utilizing the antenna. Your car's radio picks up that signal, utilizing its own antenna. This can be as simple as a wire or a metal stick. In conjunction with the tuner on your radio tuning to the specific frequency, the tuner starts resonating at 680 kilohertz. Called resonance, this principle allows the radio to essentially ignore any other signals in the air.
Everything has a range of frequency, including every organ and cell in our bodies. Scientific research has shown that our cells resonate with and respond to different frequencies. When we are in resonance, or the act of resonating and producing positive feeling states, we are in balance. Music based on 432 hertz creates resonance within our bodies and balances the emotional and mental state. It transmits beneficial healing energy because it's a pure tone of math fundamental to nature. But you may be surprised to know that our current musical standard is a tuning of 440 hertz. So when did this concert pitch come into effect? Most music worldwide has been tuned to 440 hertz since the International Standards Organization, or the ISO, endorsed it in 1953. There is a theory that the change from 432 hertz to 440 hertz followed the recommendations of a Nazi Party spokesman, Joseph Goebbels, in 1939. According to this theory, there was an organized effort to change concert pitch to 440 hertz at the start of the last century to codify an old world new order of central pitch. This was set into motion in order to increase anxiety levels in individuals, causing them to think and feel in specific ways, making them a prisoner of a consciousness that breeds disharmony. It's also alleged that the Rockefeller Foundation had an interest in making sure the United States adopted the 440 hertz standard as a part of a war on consciousness, causing more emotional distress and in turn more physical illness and hardship. Whether these theories are true or not, one thing is certain: the frequency that music is tuned to has a profound effect on us. This is not just a spiritual concept, it's mathematically and scientifically proven.
Stop shitting us, man. Look, pop stars, they're the ones who influence the masses. We're just a rock band.
Oh, pop stars are so fucking boring. Anyway, I've got most of them.
Thank you.
Jay-Z, Empire State of Mind. I love that lyric. Jesus can't save you. Life starts when the church ends. And then his little protege, Kanye. You know, I put him on the front of Rolling Stone magazine with a crown of thorns on his head. Total fucking blasphemy. You know, that guy's got over 20 Grammys. That's more than the Beatles, Neil Young, and Elvis put together. I mean, even I'm embarrassed by that. Ah, Cassandra, thank you, darling. Thank you very much.
You're welcome, Mr. Capricorn.
Mr. Capricorn? Did you hear an echo? Okay, right, look. Why exactly a band like us? Rock and roll. Heavy metal. You know, you guys, you're so loyal to me. You wear me on your sleeve. But your fans are dangerous, and your fans are full of passion.
Oh, whatever, mate. Fucking mental.
Have you ever seen Iron Maiden? Stadiums full of their fans
singing along to songs like The Number of the Beast. Or what about Van Halen?
Running with the Devil, The Stones, Sympathy for the Devil. I mean, on and on and on and on it goes. I'm not saying I'm Satan, just saying that the devil is a catchy lyric.
Thank you. brought me and Willie around on Saturday night, yeah, Willie Brown. And every time we stopped for rest and said, we'll get out over the corner or something and go out to catch air, you know, get the guitar and be trying to play and be just noising the people, you know. And the folks would come out and say, why don't y'all, some of y'all go in and meet that boy and put that, get that thing down, he's running us crazy. Finally, he let me run off from his father and mother. And he went over in Arkansas or someplace. He was gone about 6 or 8 months. So then he come back. When he come back, me and Willie Brown was playing out to him, and he walked in. He said, can I hear the book of tunes? I said, nah, don't come back to that, Robert. I said, you know the people don't want to hear that racket. He said, that, let them say what they want to say. I want you to see what I like.
Live on the scene of a murder that happened late last night. And although details are very sketchy, we do know that one of the shooting victims is rapper Snoop Doggy Dogg. There was apparently a lot of gunfire here.
Aquí abrazaron el Snoop Doggy Dogg. No sabemos por qué es motivo, pero...
Starts tripping, a tear drops my eye. My body temperature falls. I'm shaking, and they breaking, trying to save the dough. Pumping on my chest, and I'm screaming. I stop breathing, damn, I see demons. Dear God, I wonder, can you save me? I can't die, my boo-boo's about to have my baby. I think it's too late for praying. Hold up, her voice spoke to me, and it slowly started saying,
bring your life down to me, you're making better.
And how long will I live?
Eternal life, then.
Let's get this equation. The right frequency and hertz, right? That controls your emotions. So the right tone of music dictates how you're going to feel with that song. The right lyrics to the song are also entering into your consciousness. Because it got you in a receptive state. Because you're receiving signals that are in the air. Right? Who's in control of all this? Who control the airwaves? Who control the record companies? Who tells these artists what they can play and say and what they can't play and say? Right? Revelation 3:9, that's who. But Ephesians 6:12, for we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. That's why certain cultures made up pseudo cultures like hip hop, trap, whatever the music, R&B, whatever the genre of music is, it basically rides a wave of society. The music and the actors and all of these different forms of media dictate the changes in society, from the way you speak, to the way you dress, to the way you think, to the way you view the world. It's powerful because it's not just music. These people study people. And they wicked as hell. Right? Let's go to the book of Wisdom of Solomon and the Apocrypha, chapter 4 and verse 12. For the bewitching of naughtiness doth obscure things that are honest, and the wandering of concupiscence doth undermine the simple mind. Let's look up that word, concupiscence. All right. Let's see. Strong sexual desire or lust, right? And the wandering of lust doth undermine the simple mind. These different songs and these different medias, avenues of media that the devil uses molds the simple mind, right? It doesn't allow the simple mind to see the truth of the matter, the truth of this world, right? That's why when you hear them brothers in the highways and hedges, including myself, that song don't resonate to you like FM and AM, like Lil whoever it is that's on top, your favorite drill rapper or whatever. You would rather hear that than the true, honest word of the Most High, because you're being ruled over, right, by individuals that practice wickedness, spiritual wickedness in high places. Most High willing, you are edified by these precepts in this video. Call Haloyim Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shai Bahashem Harakar Kodash Shalom Yashal.